What's up you guys, this is the Sineth. Welcome you all to another random tutorial. So today we are going to implement a finger gesture controlled ball catcher using Python and related modules. So before we are going to move our tutorial, so I would like to tell you that, so if you are interested in deep learning, machine learning, computer vision, image processing, or any of the field regarding to software engineering or computer science, please subscribe to my channel and hit on the bell icon. I am planning to do different kind of tutorials, projects, and interesting stuff throughout my channel, right? Okay, let's move on to our tutorials today. So the topic of our tutorial is finger gesture control ball catcher, right? So all the implementations regarding to our tutorial is going will be done by Python language and the related modules such as MediaPipe, right? Okay, let me to explain you about the behavior, the functionalities of our application, right? Okay, so today's our application is actually a game. Right, it is actually a ball catching game. So what is mean by a ball catching game? So ball catching means the balls are moving, right? Think about the balls are moving in a particular space, so we can pick any ball. So the picked balls are considered as catched balls, right? So whenever we have picked a ball, that particular ball will be considered as a catched ball, right? Likewise, our application is also going to display balls from bottom to top, right? From bottom to top, it will generate a particular number of balls and move to our application. Then those balls are going to be moved from bottom to top, right? So the balls are available in this space, so we can catch any of the ball using our fingertips, right? So we can use our index finger of any of left or right or both in a certain time. So we can pick any of the ball in the screen, right? It's actually virtual, right? So we can use a video source like webcam, right? Using the webcam, we can see the application, and when we are seeing the balls are moving, so we can point out our index fingers, right? We can point out our index fingers, and we can catch any of our interested fingers. So whenever we have placed our tip of index finger to a particular region of a ball, that ball will be considered as a catched ball, right? So whenever we have point out our the tip of our index finger on a circle, that circle will be considered as a catch circle, right? So whenever we have missed a circle, which means the circle is going from down to top, at that time we were unable to pick out that ball. So that ball will be missed. That ball will be moving from bottom to top, and it will be popping out from our application. So it will be lost, right? So at that moment, that kind of balls will be considered as a missed ball, right? So in our application, there are only two type of balls. Only if a certain ball is going to be missed, it will not be catched. If a certain ball going to be catched, then it will not be missed, right? Right, there are only two type of balls in our application. If some ball has captured already, it has already catched, then it will be considered as catched ball. If we have lost or we have missed any ball, then that kind of balls will be counted as missed balls, right? That's all about the word explanation regarding to our application. So let's move on to a demonstration program. It means a working example of our application, right? So I have created a bunch of a piece of code regarding to a presentation of our application. So it is a working example of our today's target application, right? So let me to execute this again. So here we go now. Okay. Okay, you can see that, right? From bottom to top, the balls are moving, right? So the all the colors, the positions, and the number of balls in the frames are totally random, right? The balls are created in a random manner. Their colors, their positions, and the number of balls in a certain time of the frame are totally random, right? So whenever I have, you can see that I my application is able to detect the fingertips of index fingers, right? So you can see the both of left and right finger, right hand's fingertips are detecting inside my application. So you can see that whenever I have catched a particular circle, that circle will be disappeared from the frame and it will be encountered as a catch circle. So you can see whenever I have catched a circle, the number of catch circles are going are increasing, right? Whenever the circles are missing from the, whenever circles are popping from the frame, those circles are encountered as missed circles. Right, so you can see separately the catch circles and miss circles respectively, right? So you can see the balls are moving in a constant speed, right? We can vary that speed inside our application also. By the way, it's only a single variable, right? So you can customize this application after this tutorial, right? And also you can see that FPS, which means a frame rate of our application, is counting in the as the first circle, right? So this column will is considered as the status panel, which means this displaying, visualizing the current status regarding to our application, right? FPS, catched, missed are current status of our application, and this is our live stream, right? It will be shown different kind. It will be shown the frames of our application, which are currently capturing through a video source of our video source, such as webcam. Right? Okay. Okay. That's all about the behaviors, functionalities of our application. So let me to explain you more deeply about the interface of our application. Right? So you can see that somewhat of you have unseen this line in our working example. So actually this is not a part of our application. I have drawn this for the explanation purposes only, right? There's no need to explain about these kind of stuffs, right? I will explain you about this annotated imaginary line, right? Okay. In the beginning of our application, right, let me explain about the idea behind this imaginary line, right? In the beginning of our application, right, there is no any ball present in the frame, right? There is no any ball present in the frame. What it is going to do behind the scene is it is creating a bulk of balls, right? A bulk of balls. The number of balls in the bulk is totally random, and their positions are totally random, and also their colors are also totally random. So the random bulk is created behind the scene in our application, then that will be moved from bottom to top, right? Then it will be started to move from bottom to top. So those balls are, the random balls are moving from bottom to top, right? Moving from bottom to top. And a cool thing about this our application is it is listening the number of balls which are currently moving under the imaginary section of our application, right? This section is not appearing for the user, right? It is a behind the scene region. So what it is doing is that our application is listening and our application is calculating the number of circles which are currently moving in the imaginary section, which means the section which is down to this particular blue line, right? This section, right? Our application is calculating the number of circles which are currently moving inside this section, which means the section which is down to this imaginary line, right? So whenever our application able to find any number of circle present in this imaginary region, it will do nothing, right? Whenever our application able to find any number of circle, which at least one, right? Our application able to find at least one circle in this particular region, it will do nothing, right? Whenever this imaginary region, right? Whenever this imaginary region empty with circles, right? So whenever this imaginary region not present any of the circle, it will create another bulk of circles behind the scene, right? It will create another number of circles, number of balls, and they are that bulk is also totally random as our previous one. Then it is going to be moved from bottom to top again. Second bulk is going to be moved from bottom to top again, right? Which means that whenever our the first bulk has passed this imaginary line, it will create another bulk and move from bottom to top behind the scene. So I think you got the point, which means why it is doing is that we have to maintain the flow of circles, right? We have to maintain the flow of circles. Whenever the number of circles in the current bulk has moved a certain amount of our application, we have to create another bulk and pass from bottom to top. Then only we will able to maintain the flow, we will able to maintain the number of circles and the movement of circles in a flowing way, right? So that's the idea behind the imaginary line. This line is not disappearing for the user, it is used for only the behind the scene works, right? It's only used for the behind the scene works. I have drawn this for the explanation purposes regarding to the final output sections, right? Okay, that's all about the imaginary section. Then you can see that my the fingertips of my index fingers have detected by some functionality, right? So for that purpose we have got the support of media pipes hands, right? We have got the support of media pipes hands. So the media pipe is a open source cross-platform, and it is also a customizable live and streaming media machine learning solution package, right? So you can refer their official website and get overall knowledge regarding to media pipe. It has mentioned everything you need to know under the media pipe, right? So you can see there are several kind of solutions. What we are interested from those are hands. We are only interested in hands because we are getting the support of media pipe hands to our today's project. So media pipe hands is a solution. Actually, it is a machine learning pipeline. So the machine learning, the media pipe hand solutions machine learning pipeline contains two models. The first model is for the palm detection, and the second model is for the landmark detection. So whenever we have passed image to our machine learning solution, then it will be identify the certain number of palms in our image using palm detection. So those images are going to be transferred to the landmark model. So you can see that this is our landmark model. So the palm detection model is here. So whenever palm detection model able to identify a palm, then it will be passed to hand landmark model. So you can see the output of palm detection model is the input of hand landmark model. Then the detected palms landmarks are going to be recognized by this hand landmark model. Not recognizing, it will be going, it will detect the landmarks of that input image of output image of the palm detection model, right? Likewise, they are maintaining their relationship and give us the detections regarding to the hands. So you can see that there are several kind of landmarks are detecting throughout the media pipes hand solution. So you can see that the palm is also there are several kind of landmarks. So let's have a look about the what are those landmarks. So you can see there are 21 number of landmarks which we can identify through, which we can get the output as the machine learning pipeline. So you can see the 0th one is for wrist, first one is thumb, second one is also for thumbs and other purpose. Likewise, we can get the 20th one, so 20th one is pinky tip, right? Likewise, we can get 21 number of consecutive landmarks as the output from this particular machine learning pipeline for media pipes, hands detection and everything, right? Okay, so if you want to refer about these media pipe hands, so I have dropped a link in the references section of this notebook, so you can click on this link and redirect to this particular web page and refer and get the overall knowledge regarding to media pipe hands. Okay, so what we are going to do with media pipe hands is that we are only interested with interested with the tip of our index finger of both hands, right? We have to capture the tip of index finger of any of the hand, left or right. So using media pipe hands, we are going to get the index finger. We are going to identify the index finger and we are going to get the landmark of eight landmark of our output. So the eighth landmark is representing the tip of index finger. Then we can get the coordinate regarding to the eighth landmark. Then we can draw this kind of visualization in the frame as the index finger of our tip of the index finger of our hands, right? So whenever a particular circle has cropped in, whenever a particular circle has overlapped in this the coordinate of the eighth landmark of our hand, which means that the ball has overlapped with our hand, then we can consider that particular overlapped circle as a catched circle, right? Likewise, we can get the live predictions using this the help of our media pipe hand solution. So this is very, very cool invention and you must follow this, and all the implementations with Python are indicate here. So you can see under the solution APIs, you can see the configuration options, the different kind of parameters and what kind of values you should have to pass through the implementation. So you can see about the outputs, right? And also the Python solution API, you can see the implementation regarding to media pipe hands can be seen throughout this section. And also there is a JavaScript solution API, right? So you can go through this particular documentation, right? So you can do many advanced things within the help of this particular service, right? Particular package, right? So you can see that using media pipe hands, we can get 21 number of consecutive landmarks. So these are the explanations regarding to those landmarks. I'm not going to talking about those things. I'm only interested about the eighth landmark. It is about the index finger tip, right? We are only interested with the index finger tip of both left and right hands, right? Okay, let's get started with the implementation. So you can see I have imported several modules of Python. So some of the import and the time module and the random are built-in modules for Python. So you don't need to install them explicitly or externally. So the only modules you have to worry about is OpenCV, NumPy, MediaPipe, and this particular model, Google Protodoc model, right? So if you haven't installed any of these modules, so you can follow up these commands in command prompt and get installed with these modules using the Python package installer called pip, right? Okay. Then what I have done is I have created a detector for my hands, right? So by the way, I'm not explaining you about the deep regarding to these implementations, right? Because it is a lot of stuffs, right? So you can see that a lot of codes can be identified as the implementation. So I'm not going to talk about everything line by line, right? So I'm only giving you an abstraction idea regarding to the implementation, so you can have a research regarding to all the implementation. So by the way, I'm going to post some GitHub and Google Drive links regarding to those these materials, so you can download and refer, and also you can implement furthermore, right? So this is my MediaPipe hand detector. So I have given a 0.8, which means 80 detection confidence for palm detector, and 80 detection confidence for tracking confidence, which means landmark detector, right? So the both confidence I have given is 80%. Then I have created a particular function. I'm not going to explain this function line by line. Actually, this function is to generate random ball coordinates. So I have to, told you that we are going to create a bulk behind the scene, right? We are going to create a bulk of circles behind the scene. So we have to create that bulk in random manner. So their positions and their colors are, everything is random. So if we select a certain ball from a frame, then its position and its color is totally random, right? The both of color and the position are totally random. So to create such kind of balls, we have created this particular function. This will generate us random ball coordinates, right? This everything is random, so you can end up with the output is ball init coordinates, which mean the random coordinates of each and every ball and their related colors, right? So you can, the output will be given as I think list, the output will be given as list. So this particular function is for that purpose, right? So I have created some important global variables for different kind of things. So you can see this is the height of my window, so the height of the application and the length of the application. Likewise, I have created different kind of variables which I am used as the global variables of the application. Then I have created a video source. Then I am going to read frame by frame, and I am going to calculate the frame rate, right? Then I am going to do some sort of things, right? I am going to create a status panel, so you can see that I am going to resize my image, right? I am going to flip my image because the captured image is every time a mirror image. So to detect our hands correctly, we have to flip that image. So if I place my left hand as inside towards my camera video source, then it will be recognized by MediaPipe as a right hand, right? Because it is already mirrored. So that's why I'm going to flip that image. Then it is going to convert into RGB manner because it's already BGR. Then that will be considered only read-only, right? Then it will be detect and some sort of things. So you can go through the MediaPipe hands of documentation, and you will be able to understand these every function and their purposes after reading this particular documentation, right? So what I have done is I have created two variables for x and y coordinates of my index finger, right? Then I'm going to find out the x and y coordinates of my index finger. and I have drawn different kind of lines and circles, right? You can see that the four lines, these four lines are for the lines around my index finger. So you can see that there are four lines around my index finger, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So this will create, this will draw that particular four lines, and this will draw two circles as the coordinate, as the point of my as representing the point of my fingertip, right? Index fingertip. Then it will append my index fingers, the index finger, the X and Y coordinates of my current index finger will be appended to this particular list, right? Okay, this bunch of code is going to maintain the speed of moving balls, right? So it will maintain the speed of moving balls by some sort of logic, right? Then what it is going on here is that it's going to get every ball, right? So get every ball, initialized coordinate of every ball, and it is going to check the y-axis. So the C stand for coordinate, right? So every coordinate contains x and y values, axis values. So the y value is less than 0, which means that ball is considered as the missed ball, right? So moving up means it will go towards the zeroth row of the matrix. So it will, if the y-axis is less than or equal to 0, means that ball is considered as the missed ball, right? So if a particular ball has passed the boundary y means that our this imaginary line, right? So I have given the y value of this imaginary line as 550, right? So whenever I have, whenever some particular ball has passed that imaginary line, then it will be considered as boundary passed ball, right? It will be considered as a boundary passed ball. So then I have popped down the released balls, right? So all the release ball, all the missed balls should be removed from the frame, right? So whenever some particular ball has missed, so it should not be visualized in the frame furthermore, right? We have to pop it and disappear from the current frame, right? So likewise, we have to disappear every missed balls, right? It will be done here. Then what it is going to done in here is that it is going to, right? Yeah, okay. So it is this bunch of code is going to right, this bunch of code is going to listen the overlapped circles, overlapped balls, which are already overlapped with our index fingers, right? Right. It is going to counter and get the coordinates of the balls which are already overlapped with our index fingers in this moment, right? So it will be identify the overlapped balls of our overlapped balls which are already overlapped with our index fingers. Then that overlapped balls are considered as cached balls, right? Because since they are already overlapped, they should be considered as cached balls, right? So that cached balls are also considered, should be removed from the frame, right? Whenever a ball has cached, then that ball should be removed, or that should be disappeared from the screen or the frame, right? Then if the boundary pass balls equal to len of initialized codes, right, which means that every ball has passed the boundary, which means that imaginary line. So every ball in the bulk As I previously mentioned, every ball in the bulk has passed the imaginary line, which means that all the balls have passed the imaginary line. We have to create another bulk, right? So that particular condition checking is going on here, right? If this is happened, we have to create another random ball coordinates, and it is going to be extend to both. It is going to extend both initialized coordinate and ball colors to the particular list, right? So whenever we have passed every ball in the current bulk, then we have to create another bulk using generate random ball coordinates function, right? Okay. Then we can draw the colors of the particular balls using this particular function. Then what we have done is we have set the image of our current panel, which means we have set the live stream frame to which we have assigned live stream frame to the application's main display, right? Okay, then I have formatted as a different kind of values which should be displayed under missed and catched, right? So you can see that. So in here, so you can see that the missed and catched values are displayed in 3 digits, right? So 3 digits, there is a relationship between the displayment of those things. So you can see that if the number of missed balls are less than 10, which means a digit, right? If the magnitude of the missed balls are a digit, then it should be formatted as, it should be displayed as 0, 0 and the number of missed balls, which means we should, every time we should display the number of missed balls as in 3 digits, right? So whenever we have only 1 digit, we have to format it to 3 digits. Whenever we have 2 digits, which means our value between 10 and 100, right? 10 and 99, including 99, which means every value contains 2 digits, we have to pre-append only 1 digit of 0. Whenever we have a value greater than 1000, which means greater than 3 digits, then we have to display that particular value in K, right? Which means that we can, as the YouTube views, so we can say 1.5K, right? Like that manner, we have to display, we have to format the missed and catch values as this manner whenever the value has increased greater than 200, right? The same procedure applied for both cached and missed values, right? Then only we will be able to see the values with 3 digits and particular manners, right? Okay. Then I have print several kind of stuff which we have to print visualized under the status panel. So you can see there are 3 circles and there are several kind of text. So you can see FPS, cached, missed, and I have hard coded their coordinates, right? So you can go through these coordinates and have a track. That doesn't matter, right? So then I have imshow the panel. Panel means my overall application's display. Then I have imshow that and wait for 1 second. If I have pressed 27, which means I have pressed the escape, then I have to terminate my application and I have to release my video source. Video source means my live streaming source, which may be my webcam or any IP camera, anything. Then I have to destroy all the windows which I have opened at this moment, right? Okay, that's all about the implementations regarding to our tutorials. So I think you have got the idea and got the points fine, right? I think I have gone through everything and I have completed everything that we should be able to complete under this tutorial, right? Okay, that's all about our tutorial today. So I think I have done my best. So if you guys have any question, any doubt, any misclarification regarding today's tutorial, so please let me know in the comment section. I am very happy to answer for your questions. So if you guys have any suggestion and if you guys have any idea regarding to my contents of my channel, so feel free to comment your suggestions in the comment section. So I will post two links to download these resources at the description link, so you can refer the description, the links that I have posted in the description, and you can download these materials and have a try, and please try to improve these things furthermore and learn a lot and refer everything which I have shared with you, and do more nice things with yourself, right? So that's all about today. So let's meet with another random tutorial. Stay safe, stay awesome, and thank you very much.